There's quite a bit more email functionality in version 12. The first thing that we'll look at here is the send email message to a group functionality. That's been an option in family mailing list, personal profiles, and activities and skills for a few versions now. In version 12, we've added this menu option to attendance, payroll, and contributions. The screen that opens from the menus will have selection criteria specific to those areas of the program. For example, here in attendance, you could send a mass email to everyone who was present or absent over a specific date range, like a follow-up email to absentees. Another option that's been in the program for a while are these little send email buttons on the family and profile screens. Previously, what would happen is it would tell your local computer to compose a new email, and your default mail client software like Outlook or Windows Mail would open and compose the message. Recently, it's more common to not have local email software installed using only a webmail client. In the case of Gmail, it would just open Google Chrome when you click the Send Email button, so that's not very helpful. There's now an option in version 12 to tell PowerChurch to send an email itself instead of trying to launch a different email program. So this option is under File, Preferences, System Setup Options. Click on the Email tab, and there's a checkbox option here at the top that reads Use PowerChurch to send messages when clicking the Email button next to Email Address fields. This is also on the User Setup options, so an individual user can override the system setting. We've also added that Send Email button to other screens where you'll find an email address field, like the Maintain List of Employees in Payroll, Accounts Payable Vendors, and accounts receivable customers. PowerChurch Plus version 9 added the ability to send contribution statements or tax receipts as an email attachment. We've expanded this functionality, so quite a few different reports can now be sent via email. The pledge statements and contributions, accounts receivable invoices, the account statements and payment statements in accounts receivable. You can send pay stubs via email in payroll, and the family update form in membership, which will hopefully make that process a lot easier and keep the membership contact information more up to date.